I feel so glamorous right now, it's practically disgusting. So I'm not going to be using foundation today. I'm just going to put a little bit of my glow screen primer on. And I'm going to do concealer in the center of my face. And then I'm going to just be contouring on the outer parts of my face. My skin is prepped, but I want to go the extra mile because this is Cher. And I'm going to use some of my e.l.f. Retro Paradise in Golden Hour and bronze my shoulders and my collarbones because Cher was a shining bronze queen in the 70s. Very important to me. This. I'm going to put some on my neck. Theme. I'm using Mycosa's concealer in number 6. And I'm going to be using concealer instead of foundation. And I'm going to plop a lot of it just, whoa, in the center of my face. So I'm just going to take my normal foundation brush and disperse this. Medium brown liner and brow cream from e.l.f. I'm going to focus on a shape for my brows that is mostly bushy in the front and kind of tapers out more thin. Whereas I'd normally go like all the way in there, I'm just going to sort of just make it sharper towards the tail end. So just a really quick run through with the brow and liner cream, and then I'm taking this BBB London Ultra Slim Brow Definer. There's no color, it's just kind of a taupe color. And lightly go under here to build some volume. Lila BB Vibrant. So I'm going to take Princess from my Real Fantasy palette, which is going to make a really good eye base. Because this eye look is luminous. There's like some shimmer in here. My Huda Beauty nude palette and go in with some of this pink right here. It's called Play. These shadows are really pigmented, so you just want to use a little bit and then really tap off. I'm just using the same fluffy brush, which might be too big, but I'm going to just give it a whirl right here. So this color is Play by Huda Beauty. Brush is a little bit too big. And then I'm going to blend out this way on the end. And then I'm going to take a smaller blending brush. I'm going to use a tiny flathead brush like this. And I'm going to go in with Inspire from the Venus XL Lime Crime palette. It's super pigmented, so just be careful. And then I'm gonna go in with like a super rounded eye shape. Start here. And then I'm gonna go in with this fuller shaped brush and blend just that line. I'm gonna go back in with this same shade, Inspire. First color we set as a base with Princess, and just go underneath my eye. So I'm going to take a little bit of this Trance shade from the Real Fantasy palette, dust a lot of it off, and go over this fuchsia quite carefully. I want to just define more into this part of my eye, so I'm going to go in with Trance and lay that right on top. Taking my mid-size fluffy brush and just blending a little bit of that together. When I feel like my eye shapes are getting blended out too far, like I feel like I went too far into my front brow on this side, I just take a Q-tip and go under here and just take some of the color away. Some drop shadow with Hoola. This big, flat, fluffy, almost Lila B brush to get some good coverage underneath my eye. And I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Eden and then the color we used before, Inspire. And just lightly just kind of tap dust the outer part of my eye. Inspire and Eden. The fluffy brush. Blend everything together with the first brush we laid the base down with. I'm going to go in and further define with the same tiny flat brush we used before, and I'm going to use Celestial, which is like a shimmery, lighter version of this Botticelli. And it's very pigmented, so I'm going to just use palm a little bit to tap that off, and then just go in really thin here. Keep getting so blown out with all of this pigment. Highlight with some of this ethereal color right here and just use my ring finger. And then I'm going in with a really small brush with Celestial and Botticelli. To further deepen that crease. A small bullet brush to blend that out, which is very important, or else you're gonna blow the whole eye shape out. The black shadow from my Claro Sykes box with a very thin, tiny brush that I love to use for eyeliner looks. And I'm just gonna press it into my lash line. Line my eyes with black. Crystalline, which is a really shimmery white. And close right here to the lash line. Just gonna add like a little highlight. White eyeliner in my waterline. This is Coconut by Morphe. And then with a richer brown, I'm gonna go in with Jupiter. Line with the brush. A little more black and going in with this tiny flat brush. Really gently, because then if you aren't careful, you can put black all around the eyes and mess everything up. But I want to smoke this out. Blend it out with this flat flyaway brush. Makeup Forever Smoky Lash. I think it'd be really pretty if I just dragged some princess underneath this whole brown smoky situation. Some lower lash on with my Aiko Lash Alert, which is my favorite mascara for bottom lash. Okay, we put two coats of bottom mascara on. Cher had a really tapered, spidery lash that would go like really long, short, really long, short, really long, short. So I'm going to recreate that with some individuals. These, I'm not sure what they are. Go in really close. Oh, that's it, that's so her. Here. But gonna go ahead and do the other side. Okay, so while these fabulous lashes dry, I'm going to do the concealer and the contour the rest of the face. I'm gonna go pretty crazy with Custard by NARS. I never would do it. Like, oh my god, why are you putting that much concealer on? But it's Cher and she's very snatched. Whoops. Highlight concealer, be vibrant. Go back in and just put mascara on the super long spidery lashes I applied. Contour, run it through the eyeshadow. This Concha Chroma by Kosas. I took a little bit of the highlighter to melt into the blush and complete the cheeks. And this I'm going to carry kind of all throughout where my contour was as well, and I'm going to blend everything down. So that's Cher, y'all. I'm feeling really extra good because one, I look like Cher right now, and two, my nails. This is the first gift anyone's ever sent me for my channel, and I'm just so touched that she thought of me and likes my videos. And please, if you are in a dire need of feeling glamorous, go and check out Belle Does Nails, her Instagram, and order yourself a kit and just do some self-care and feel glamorous, okay? Feel like Cher. If you liked the Cher look, make sure you like and subscribe. What would Cher do? Cher would subscribe to my videos, I think. The product breakdown for this look will be in my Instagram, so make sure you follow me on Instagram, SoftGlam. And I will see you next time.